Are you tired of hearing the sound of your neighbor's dogs barking all night? Are you exhausted because all you can hear when you're trying to sleep is the nearby highway? You might think the foam insulation is the answer to all of your prayers when it comes to sound deadening, but I am here to tell you that may not be how it works. I'm gonna drop a little science on you. So let's get nerdy. Just a little warning before we get started. If you are listening to this with headphones in or on, you're going to want to turn down the volume because I'm going to give you a live demonstration of sound deadening, and it's going to get a little bit loud, and I'm talking over 100 decibels loud. So I'm going to drop some numbers on you. Now, when it comes to blocking sound transmission in your home, there's a lot to consider. Your average wall is about 30 to 40 STC. What that means is, like, you're going to hear some loud conversations outside, you're going to hear some traffic, but the wall itself and the windows will block some of that noise. But depending on how your house is built, that noise transmission is going to vary. Now, in this, before we get to our live demonstration, I want to just talk about decibels a little bit, some things that are on the safer side of noise levels, some things that are on the more harmful side of noise levels. That way you have a good idea of what is around your home and how that affects the sound that comes inside. When we think about sound transmission, you have to really understand where things fall as far as decibels. Normal breathing, it's about 10 decibels. Unless you've got a heavy breather, close breather, that's uncomfortable, probably a little louder. A residential area, they consider to be about 40 decibels, and that's the sound coming from outside. This doesn't account for any kind of, like, your wall or windows, your home's construction, anything like that. This is literally just what the sound is measured at. A normal conversation ends up being about 60. Heavy traffic hits all the way up to 85. Now, depending on where your home is located, this actually could come into play. If you live near a highway, you're going to hear traffic a lot more than if you live on a quiet street. So now let's take a look at some of the things that are a little bit louder on that decibel scale, and they fall under the harmful noise levels. That only means if you work constantly around some of this stuff, then you would have to worry about your hearing. For this point, we're just looking at the decibels so that you have a good idea of sound transmission and how loud these things are. Is your neighbor outside mowing the lawn? That's going to be significantly louder and you'll be able to hear it inside. Do you live near a hospital? Can you hear the ambulances as they approach? Do you live near a train station or railroad tracks? That's also going to be significantly louder. You can see here where these rank on the decibel chart. And in a second, when we do our live demonstration, this is gonna make a whole lot more sense. Anytime I can do a little bit of science and get nerdy, I get real excited. This is just a wooden box that used to have RetroFoam in it because we used to use it for sound demonstrations. This one is empty and this is going to be our control box. Another handy scientific tool I have is a sound level meter. Right now, it's reading, I'm talking, it's about 70 because I'm talking a little bit louder than the average normal conversation that I discussed before. We're going to use this to get a reading of how loud the alarm is and how loud it is after it's placed inside the box. Now, once again, I am going to warn you, this is loud. This actually registers from a test that we did earlier at about 104 decibels. That's loud enough to really hurt your hearing. So if you're wearing headphones or earbuds, now is the time to take them out. I'm going to pull the pin and we're going to do a reading before I put it in the box. That was right at 109 decibels. Now I'm going to turn it back on, put it inside the box, and take another reading. Right now the meter is reading at about 85, 86. So that did dampen the sound just a little bit, just from being inside the wooden box. Here we have another box that we use for sound demonstrations. This one actually has RetroFoam inside of it. You can see here, there's a nice thick layer here. There's also a nice thick layer inside of the box. So now what I'm going to do is this alarm that we've already tested hit about 109 decibels. I'm going to place it inside the box and close it, and then we're gonna do another reading. It's right around 60 to 62 decibels. As you can see, that's about a 20 decibel difference. But while that might seem great, there's a lot more to consider. I'm gonna tackle that right now. So now that I've given you a very loud demonstration on how RetroFoam works, let's be realistic here. This is not a great example of your home. This is just a wooden box with RetroFoam in it. Your home has windows, it has doors. There's a lot to consider when you think about sound transmission. Now, this is great in that it does show that one of the added benefits of RetroFoam is that it does have sound deadening qualities. Like I said, it was about 20 decibels quieter. That's great, but while all this might be true, this is not a great representation of your home. The way your home was built, the materials that they used when they built it, how many windows do you have? Those sorts of things come into play. That's why we always say an added benefit of RetroFoam is that it does have sound dampening qualities. We won't say this is absolutely what you should do to reduce noise because every home is different and every result will be different depending on the construction. So yes, RetroFoam does have sound dampening qualities. It's not going to completely soundproof your home. There's whole other materials made specifically for that. But if you want to learn more about all the cool things RetroFoam can do for your house, check out the Learning Center on our website. You're going to find tons of great articles and videos that tackle things like sound, like comfort, and like energy efficiency. I'm your building science brainiac reminding you to bring a little science to every project.